Today, we're teaming up with Couples Fitness, and I have one of the fittest couples I know joining me. I've got Tiki Barber and his wife, Tracy. Thanks so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having us.
And I know you guys are a super fit couple just by looking at you.
We try.
I have some ideas for how you can work out together and maybe even the playing field even a little bit.
That's
I got
perfect.
Some aces up my sleeves, all right? So the first thing we're gonna do is an exercise for your lower body. It's a form of a wall sit or a squat, and instead of using a wall, you guys are gonna lean against each other.
Uh-oh. You know I have a big butt, right?
Well, you know what?
No
cheating and no sitting on that ledge, okay? It's still gotta be back to back. All right, so Tiki, I'm just gonna pull you over here. Tracy, I'm gonna turn you around. You guys are gonna set up back to back, just like that, all right? Now, from here, just walk your feet out a little bit so that you can drop into a squat.
I have to trust her.
Oh,
all right. You guys, no beating each other up. I can already see the rivalry. And what you're gonna do now is lower down, bottom to bottom, and drop into a squat, just like that. Good. Now, I'm going to go grab a cup of coffee. I'll be back in about 10 minutes, and you guys just hang tight.
No, I got to sit here for
a while. That is the idea. So you want to do this for time. You can come up on it out of that without falling over. But that's the whole idea, is really to just use each other like you would use a wall.
You got to support me. Let's try that again.
Let's try one more time, all right?
You're leaning back too far.
So what I want you to do, now here's the way that you can kind of cheat it just a little bit.
God.
Walk your feet out a little further. That way you're leaning back into okay, there you go. Now go ahead. You didn't hear what I said, Tiki. Good.
Oh, much easier.
Now, does he feel more supported?
I do.
And you can even notice that Tracy's getting stronger by the second. Can you feel that, Tiki?
Wow.
Tracy's getting a little stronger.
Are you gaining weight over there? I thought
all right.
The opposite.
So now this is something that obviously we're going to do for time, not a number of repetitions.
Yes.
So this is an exercise you can easily do together. I would suggest holding it for maybe 30 seconds. I think, you know, I grew up wrestling, and I did a lot of wall sits. Football players do them too?
We do more explosive. So
explosive stuff. We
down and explode up.
Gotcha.
So the idea here is to go down and stay.
Uh-huh.
And then come up.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
You just wanna stick it. I gotta tell you the truth. I think that my wrestling coach growing up just used these to torture me. Because I don't know how that really translated to my performance as a wrestler.
You get the muscle failure is kind of the idea.
No,
right?
you get mental failure. Is what you get. All right. Now, the next one we have is going to be a push of war. We've all heard about a tug of war, okay? Yeah, no knuckle cracking,
okay.
All right? We're gonna keep it friendly today. I do have some boxing gloves over there, though, if it goes there. But we're gonna do a push of war. So what I'd like you to do is lock hands with each other. So you're gonna interlock your fingers, okay? And the idea is to keep the elbows just a little bit bent, okay? So you wanna keep them just a little bit bent. You don't wanna lock it out because when you lock out your elbow, you can hyperextend it. The last thing you wanna do is give yourself a submission hold, all right? So you wanna keep your elbows just a little bent, just like that. Now, Tracy, I'm gonna give you the same advice again, and I'm gonna challenge Tiki to actually stay more upright. That way he has less leverage on you. So move your feet a little further back, okay?
Perfect.
Now you got a little more force going into him. Now this is both upper and lower body, obviously. Tiki's a little more upright, okay? The idea is to push each other to the other side of the room, okay? You don't have to actually go there, though.
I can.
We're going to go on a count of
three. I'm going to win this. I can tell already.
Ready? On three. One.
You have to actually try.
Two.
I'm trying.
Three. And go. That's it. Come on. All right. I'm going to give Trace
a come on
now.
I see how it's working. I'm getting double teamed.
Now, I got to tell you, we're going to try that one more time. The great thing about this is even if you're resisting it a little bit. So in other words, even if you're like, all right, you know what? I'm letting her win a little. And as men, we're smart enough to know that we need to let you win just a little bit, right? So what we're going to do is let you win just a little bit,
okay.
And you still get all the benefits of this exercise. So you're really going to get a back and forth kind of vibe going on here. Okay.
Right.
So you can, I'm not going to count you off.
Don't actually push me off the mat and I won't push you.
Ready? But really get that vibe of actually fighting back and forth a little bit. And that's it. And Tiki's going to play nice and go back a few steps.
Oh, come on. So
he's going to play nice. And then Tiki's going to push me up forward and you're going to get a little work moving backwards now. That's okay. You can get a little work moving backwards. And now Tiki's going to get a little work moving backwards. And we have a nice little, now the best way to end this one is you stay right there. This is very important to the exercise. And then at the very end, you bring it in.
Aww.
And you give each other a kiss. There you go. That way we don't make it too much of a war, all right? Now, the last thing that we're going to do is we're going to do partner push-ups, okay?
Goody.
Now, usually it's very tough to do push-ups or a chest, or upper body workout with a man because, quite frankly, we're built a little more, you know, top-heavy and we're stronger up top, okay? It goes without saying. The way to even it out is we're going to throw a little bit of weight on Tiki's back. The way we're going to do it is by using you, okay?
Perfect.
So here's how we're going to set up. Tiki, if you could set up sort of like right there, that would be perfect. All right. Now, Tracy, you're actually going to face away from Tiki like that. Okay. And I'd like you to go down into a push-up position. And you're going to put your feet on his back.
Okay.
Now, don't enjoy it too much.
I'm sorry, I like this.
Okay.
Already.
So you're going to do it just like that. Now, I want you to lower down to the ground. You can just rest for a moment. And can you do a push-up off the ground?
Okay.
Okay. So here's what we're going to do. On three, you're both going to push up at the same time. Ready?
Make sure you get that count right, Tiki.
One, two, and three. There you go. Back down and up. Good. And this is really nice because not only does it build physical synchronicity, but it builds emotional synchronicity as well. Don't you feel your hearts beating as one?
Am I helping you?
Yes, you are.
All right, let's get one more rep out so we get a little bit of a workout in. Very good. And let's break. Let's go ahead and stand it up. Those are a lot of fun. I always like to ask, out of all the moves that we did, which is the one that you're going to stick to?
I like the push-ups. Push-ups and sit-ups are my thing.
Okay.
So. I like the pushing one.
Pushing one?
Pushing
one. Yeah, pushing Tiki backwards?
Yes, it makes my arms feel much stronger.
All right.